Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Emmanuel here, and in today's video I want to show you how you can run ads on Google, right? So if you come over to let me show you an example. For instance, here if I type in Bluehost, let's say I want to create a WordPress website, right? And I want to use Bluehost, and you can see from my search Bluehost here, the first four results are ads actually, right? So these are all ads targeting this keyword Bluehost, right? So these are examples of Google ads, right? Also, if you check some blogs, some website, you'll see banner ads showing up, popping up, and all those stuff. Those are Google ads as well, all right? All those stuff are Google ads, and also with Google ads you can run ads targeting YouTube. So in this video I want to show you how you can set up Google ads even if you are a complete beginner, right? And you know, Facebook and Google are the two biggest advertising networks on the internet, and I've created a lot of Facebook ads videos on this channel. And but in this video right now, I'll show you how you can run ads on Google, right? So all I need you guys to do before we continue is to take 2 seconds of your time and give this video a like, click the thumbs up button below. I really appreciate that. Also, if you're new to the channel, you're welcome. My name is Emmanuel, and what I do on this channel is to create videos that will help you make money online. And if that's something that you're interested in, if you want to learn about online business, tap the subscribe button right now. Also, turn on notifications so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video, right? So to get started with Google Ads, you need a Google Ads account. So let me just open a new tab and show you how to get that ready. So I'm going to show you how you can set up your Google Ads account and create your first ads on Google, right? So just visit ads.google.com, right? So here, what you want to do now, this if you don't have a Google Ads account already. So this, I'll assume, is for complete beginners. So you just click on start now. All right, so you want to enter your email, right? You want to basically sign into your Google account if it's not signed in yet on your browser, right? So when you log in for the first time, you will see these steps here that will want you to create your first ad, right? But what you can do, you can come over to the bottom here, right? And then click switch to expert mode so that you can have access to your ad account right now before going ahead to set up ads, okay? All right, then here you can as well start setting up your ad, but also you can come over here and click create an account without setting up your campaign, but you have to set up your billing information before you start your ad, right? So let's say you want to create your first ad. You see there are different objectives you can choose from here. Do you want sales, right? Do you want leads? Want website traffic, product and brand consideration, brand awareness and reach, app promotion, local store visits, create a campaign without a ghost guardian, right? So whatever your objective is, if you want to make sales, or you can go for whichever one you want, but let's say you want to drive traffic to our website, right? So to a particular website, right? So for this video, I want to promote Bluehost as an affiliate, right? So that's what I'll use as an example here, right? So I'll just select traffic. So here you want to select your campaign type, right? Search, you want you to appear in search result, just like in the example I showed you at the beginning of this video. You want to create a display campaign, right? Now these ads that will help you appear in people's blogs, people's websites, applications, and those stuff, right? Video ads and all those things, right? So you just select. But the best is search, right? I prefer search because I've observed gives me the best result, and traffic also gives me the best result. Regardless of whether I want to generate leads or make sales, I always go for website traffic and then I always go for search. But you can always test to see which gives you the best result, right? Then here you want to enter your website, your business website. So for me, I'll just use Bluehost. Remember, I told you I want to promote Bluehost as an affiliate here. So I'll just enter Bluehost. And then you want to pick a campaign name. So let me just use right? Bluehost. Okay, so once you are done with this, you can click on continue. Our goal is website traffic. Okay, so where do you want the networks you want to also appear? Is the site network, display network, right? If you want to appear on display networks, you leave this checked, but I don't want display networks, I just want search network, right? So here you select the location you are targeting. Is it all countries? You want to target just your country, or you can enter anywhere you want, like, right? So let's target all countries and territories. But usually you want to use Google Keyword Planner to find out where to target, right? Based on the location that has the best demand for your product. So for instance, since I'm promoting Bluehost, I'll just target United States, right? So once you've selected your location, your language, default language is English, but you can always use the language you want, right? You can add audience segment if you want. Then here you want to enter a budget. Let's say I want to go for $25 per day. You can enter any budget you want right here. Okay, then for the bidding, you are bidding for clicks. Then you want to set cost per click limit, right? So this will help regulate how much you spend, how much Google will charge you per click you get from this ad, right? So let me say I'm using 0.05, right? You can cap your CPC to whatever you want, but I'll just use this. Then here you can add extensions if you want, right? And then those are just suggestions Google is giving you. You can get up to 15% higher click-through rate by showing additional information on your ads, right? So if you want to do that, but I don't want to do that, I'll just click save and continue. Now at the ad group level, you can name your ad group if you want. This is just for identification, it does not really matter, right? So for the keyword section, you want to enter the keywords you are targeting, right? Based on the website and the business website I'm using, these are the keywords Google is suggesting that I use, right? Now when entering your keywords, there you should note that adding symbols, right, like adding quotation marks and this block bracket here, has significance, right? So adding your keyword without any symbol gives you broad match, right? So people can just search for anything related to Bluehost login and my ad could appear there. But if I add quotation marks here, that means only searches that have this phrase will see my ads, right? But if I want people to see my ads only when they search for this exact keyword, that means I'll have to put this blocked bracket here, right? So that's the significance of all the symbols. So you see all the keywords Google is recommending, but you can use Google Keyword Planner to do your research and find out the keywords you want to target, right? So let me say I want to use just Bluehost. All right, so usually you want to create different ad groups targeting different keywords so that you can really see what's giving you the best results and focus on that, right? So once you are done, you can add more ad groups targeting different keywords and all those stuff by clicking add new ad, this plus new ad group here. So I'll just click save and continue. All right, so here you want to enter your final URL, right? Where are you directing your traffic to, right? So I'll just enter my affiliate link here. All right, so you can also enter display part, what you want people to see as the URL they will click, right? So I'll just pick this and use it here, right? So by the right here, you see a preview of how your ad is gonna appear in search, right? Both on mobile and on desktop, you have a preview of what it's going to look like, right? Then you can add up to 15 different headlines, right? And you can pin these headlines based on how you want them to appear here. So these are the headlines Google picked out for me, but you can change them if you want. You can type in the headlines you want. So let's say I'll just go with this. Also for description, you can add up to 4 descriptions. Google has given me 3, and then you can pin the descriptions based on how you want them to appear here. right? So you can type in your descriptions if you want, but I'll just go with the ones Google is showing me here, right? So you see a preview of how your ad will look like when it starts running on Google, right? So once you are done setting up the ad, you want to click save and continue. All right, so here you need to set up your billing information, right? So you want to enter how you want to pay for the ad, okay? Enter your country, your time zone already automatically set for you. If you have a discount code, you can enter it here, right? Your organization name, you can enter them here as well. Then the payment method, as the card details, the billing address, and then how you want to pay for the ad. You want to pay manually or automatically, you can set that here. If it's manual, you have to fund your ad account, but if you are using automatic payment, you just link your card and then Google will do the debit, right? So once you've entered your billing details, you want to click submit, and then you publish your ads, and then your ads will start running on Google, right? So this is how you set up ads on Google. And with Google, you can literally sell anything, right? Because you are targeting warm traffic, people who are actually looking for what you are promoting. Unlike Facebook, where you are targeting based on interest, here you are targeting based on what people are actually searching for, right? And that can give you better results actually, right? So this is how you set up ads on Google. I hope this helps you, and if it does, click the like button. If you have any question or you need further clarifications, just let me know in the comment section below. And if you are yet to subscribe to the channel, you don't want to miss the next video that is coming up on this channel, so tap the subscribe button right now, hit the bell icon, and be notified whenever I upload the next video. So thank you so much guys for watching this video. I'll see you guys in the next video.